Hey guys, it's F9, also known as Yashayin, and I'm here with a daily reading for S, if you resonate with me. This is for you. I'm gonna start doing videos as much as I can, probably every day, I like a daily read until I find out what else it is I like to do or want to do for this channel. So if y'all wondering what I'm putting on me, it's Florida water. You're not supposed to use it by itself, but I do. It makes me feel like whatever energy that's lingering from when I was asleep is just like off me now. Sometimes I just like sprinkle it on myself, but that's what I was using. So with my readings, daily readings, I pull from three different decks and pretty much one card from different decks. And if I'm guided to pull more, I'm guided to pull more. So the song that comes to mind when I wake up in the morning today, this morning, was Bounce Back by Big Sean. And I'm feeling like it's a pretty somber morning, kind of like a calm, either a calm before a storm or a calming after a storm, I feel guided to say. And maybe I'm gonna say a calming after the storm, right? Yeah, only because Bounce Back is pretty much like you went through some bullshit. Now you're finally in a space where you feel yourself literally healing. Like, you know how you get a scar and it's gross for the first week? Yeah. It's gross for the first week, but then like the second week it starts to get all itchy and stuff. And then after all the itching is done, it starts to get a little darker. You can see it like literally getting normal again. That. The first card that I pulled you guys, we got a soulmate card. So yeah, this could be dealing with a soulmate. Doesn't have to be romantic. Could be family. Could be a close friend. But soulmates, it could be dealing with more than one person. It's represented by the number 41. 41, the vibration is the 4, and I just saw a vibration. It's wild. So a 4 is wholeness, structure, organization, logical thinking. Your angels are definitely surrounding you and giving you pointers whenever they can, every time, all the time. And 1 is about self, so maybe you had to like cut loose some ends with people that you looked at as soulmates, or someone very close to you. Maybe with somebody in your soul tribe. But, 2 wants to come out, but not yet. We got a Knight of Wands in reverse for the second card. Knight of Wands, reverse. Wands represents Leo energy, Aries energy, and Sagittarius energy. I can even see air here. Air signs, Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. But Knight of Wands is usually someone who's taking action. Somebody has stopped taking action within this soulmate relationship that's on your mind today. And also, I'm hearing soulmate to a few of you. Soulmate can also be a passion of yours, like a business or a hobby. Or not even a hobby, I don't like the word hobby. A passion of creation. Yeah, oh, we're gonna just do with soulmates for the majority of you guys, because we got compassion with Kuan Yin out within my goddess deck. Kuan Yin represents having compassion, unconditional love, forgiving people who've done you wrong, not being too hasty or irrational when it comes to beefs or a situation like that. She says, release any judgment about yourself and others and focus on the love and light that is within everyone. So no matter who has done you wrong, even if you wronged yourself, you need to let it go. And then next we get out new life, because this is what you want. You want a new beginning. You're ready for a new life. And this could even be you coming into terms with the idea of wanting to forgive yourself or someone else, or wanting to accept someone for who they are. But always remember, just because you accept and love someone, even though they wronged you or they're a wrong person overall, it does not mean you need to put yourself around them. And this could be what this is about. Or you could be letting go and letting God with this Knight of Wands in reverse. It's kind of like a passion that's just been stopped. Maybe you're going to stop putting yourself out there to be with this person or make it work. Or maybe you're going to stop trying to please everyone else and take the time to have unconditional love for yourself, because you want your new beginning, which is represented by 39. So 3 is the All Master Creator card. I like to call it the Christ number, a Michael, Archangel Michael number. Pretty much just being very in tune with spirit and allowing spirit to co-create with you on this planet. And then 9 is just like almost an end to a cycle. So like I was saying, like the scar is almost healed, but there's still a few more tweaks you gotta make here and there before you get to the All Master Completion number, which is like 10. And then 3 and 9, it goes to 12, which falls on to 3 again. So that's just like double confirmation for you wanting to like have a new life and create something completely new for yourself. Once again, you can be dealing with air sign, or you are an air sign, or you could be putting on the traits of air sign, which means really good at communication within yourself and others, and being detached from an emotional situation. Next tarot we got is, Page of Wands. So, you want to be free. That is next to this little new life card. More fire energy, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. You want to be free. You want to be in a very youthful mindset, where you're just breaking free from any bondages. You're finding a way to just maneuver in life and move. Even though there may be like high grass and high plants appearing in your way, you're being able to like maneuver and like bend them over to peek over it and continue to move forward. Or I'm even hearing chopping the fuck down for y'all. Like, y'all are not playing with y'all freedom. You want to be out of this stop of energy. Why this can mean, let's see. Irritation of water, page of wands, confirmation. So we may be breaking free from feelings of frustration of not being able to make a decision. Sometimes when this fork in the road upside down, reverse, so it's usually you and you're just like, oh, fuck it, I'm not gonna make a decision at all. And maybe that's literally what frees you from this bind. Like, maybe if some of you have been stuck in a situation where you have had a soulmate who you are not, like, really fucking with right now. And this is just a disclaimer. I am very raw. I curse. I say whatever comes through me naturally. So if you're conservative, then this ain't for you. Alright? But what I'm hearing is that, with this page of wands, you're breaking free, you're looking for liberation, you're looking for action, you're looking for adventure now. And instead of being tied down to actually making a decision, which is stopping you, which is making you a Knight of Wands in reversed, it's literally have pushed you to the point where you're just like, I ain't gonna make a decision at all, it is what it is. Or on the other hand, you could be super frustrated with it and overwhelmed to the point where it actually universe pushes you to not making a decision at all. Fork in the road It's telling you have two ways to go. You were fighting between, do you go to being a show monkey you're marrying or an owl? Because as you see, there's like a monkey on top of this arrow trying to play a jester. Where he at? Right here. And then there's a llama, deer, whatever. And then there's this little owl over here on his back. And the owl's kind of guiding you. You are this deer llama, okay? You're looking for wisdom, but the owl's right on your back. It's kind of like the monkey is guiding you to go into a stupid direction and maybe show up your ass because he looks like a show monkey. Or you could be this owl that's just sitting back here chilling, kind of like your higher self talking to you, kind of like spirit talking to you, like, nah, don't make a decision at all right now. And Fork in the Road is represented by the number 13, which is one of my favorite numbers. It's just like a high goddess number for me, which is guiding me to pull another goddess card. But it's the vibrations of three, of course, what I explained before, which is creativity. Again, we got three times. And then one is which is self. So this is your self-creation. This is your story. Okay, you are literally in control of whatever direction you want to go to have this new life manifest for you. I'm going to pull one more goddess card. And that concludes our daily, because this is daily energies. So this could be what you've already felt for some of you. Some of you might be feeling this energy today. Some of you could be feeling it next week or tomorrow. But whenever you say this, if this resonates, then that's really all that matters. Cora, beautiful card. This is all about blossoming into something new, like a flower blooming, that energy. Mara Cora is literally blossoming, and she says, you are getting started, so have patience with yourself in the process. Do not give up. So this is a process. This is a slow-moving process, and remember, flowers bloom overnight. Like, just because you might feel under the dumpster, but you're still feeling a little stuck, just know that you're literally almost at the end. You're at the finish line. You see the finish line at this point. You see the scar healing up, and you're like, next week it's going to be normal. You're blossoming into something. I'm being encouraged to read an excerpt from Arakora in my Goddess Tarot book. So, give me 1 second. Arakora, blossoming. You are just getting started, so have patience with yourself in the process and do not give up. In many ways, you are like a flower bud who is ripe and ready to open and grow. Don't try to rush this process, as it's a part of your beautiful path. Enjoy learning new knowledge and skills. Take your time to gather new ideas. Nurture your body with plenty of fresh air. I was saying yesterday in my Scorpio reading, was it Scorpio or Leo? I'm not sure. But meditate in nature, walk in nature. You don't have to literally meditate, but just go outside and take a nice walk and get fresh air, and I promise it will change your life. Get sunshine, nurture yourself with sunshine, water, be very hydrated, y'all. It's a very dry season. And please try to eat healthy foods. No fast food. I've been doing really bad lately with fast food because I just moved, and I haven't really been in the groove of cooking again yet. So I myself have to get better with eating healthier, and I have 2 grocery stores literally in walking distance, so I'm really bugged. Yeah. Soon enough, you'll get the unmistakable signal that it's time to put your learning into action. Spend time among flowers or be work around flowers. Get flower essences like oils and sprays to make you feel womanly and good. Yesterday for the daily reading, I had pulled Aphrodite, who is the goddess of just like loving herself, sexual energy, getting very in tune with her feminine side. And I feel that for us for this entire week. So like I just said, I was putting Florida Water on me, which is just like a floral scent, and I've been feeling good ever since. I love rose oil and rose scented things. I spray myself with rose water spray all the time on my face to hydrate myself, because it hydrates your skin. But I also like orchid. I make an orchid oil. So if any of you guys are interested in, you know, any flower scents, I got you. Like, I just got you. More meetings for Aracora. She's telling us to, we should slow down, be patient with the process, get involved with gardening, and use aromatherapy, like I was just explaining, with the floral scents and all that stuff, and or flower essences, and keep your faith at all times. Yeah, just a roundup today. You could be dealing with a soulmate connection that kind of got you bogged down because there was like maybe no more communication, no more passion within it, no more action being taken to go further than where y'all wanted to go. And you're being guided to forgive them for whatever they've done to you. Forgive yourself. Just let it go. Let God, let go and let God. You are able to be free from this situation, this gunk feeling, this burden, if you will. It's stunting. It was stunting your passion and your drive in the past. And maybe it's even stopped a lot of projects for you because you weren't able to focus on it, because it was at the back of your mind so much that you kind of lost inspiration. But you want this new life to start. You want to free yourself with this Page of Wands, and you want to start a new life completely. You could be dealing with the air, fire signs, what I'm seeing in this reading, or a little earth, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Because you were at a crossroads at one point, and you kind of just became either so frustrated that you just didn't make a decision to like to move forward or not, or to wait for them or not, or you're just like on some shit where you're like, I live in God's hands at this point. I'm not going to continue to frustrate myself with making a decision of staying or going mentally. This is mentally. The wise owl wants you to just let it go, because it is a slow process, and you're aware of that, and you're almost at the finish line, and you're blossoming. So yeah, that's pretty much what I got for you guys today. If you want a personal reading, I do those for donation-based only. You must give up a minimum of $3.33 to receive a personal reading. Like I was saying, I encourage you guys to get flora-scented perfumes, colognes, or water sprays, or oils. I make them. If you want to request me to make you some, I can. Email me and I'll hit you back with prices. Yeah, thank you guys for tuning in. If you like this video, like it. That helps me get seen more. I'm just starting back. If you want to share it, that's cool. That would be great. And I love you guys, and have a great day.